Good morning, children. Welcome back to maths class. In the last class, we have studied addition of integers, right? In today's class, we are going to see the subtraction of integers. But before that, should know the additive inverse of a number. Okay? So, additive inverse of a number. Additive inverse of a number or an integer. Okay? So if a is an integer, then its additive inverse is minus a. If a is an integer, then its additive inverse is minus a. How will you obtain a number's additive inverse? You have to multiply the given integer with minus 1 so that you will be getting its additive inverse. For example, minus 6. Minus 6 is an integer. What is the additive inverse of minus 6? Additive inverse of minus 6 is minus 6 into minus 1, which is equal to positive 6. So the additive inverse of minus 6 is positive 6. Then what will be the additive inverse of positive 6? Positive 6. What is the additive inverse of positive 6? Multiply the 6 with minus 1, you will get the additive inverse. So, 6, positive 6 into minus 1, which is equal to minus 6. So, the additive inverse of minus 6 is positive 6, whereas the additive inverse of positive 6 is minus 6. Okay? So, in general, if a is an integer, then its additive inverse is minus a. Okay? If minus a is taken as an integer, then its additive inverse is positive a. So this is about additive inverse. Now let's move to the subtraction of integers. Subtraction of integers. In the last class we have studied the addition of integers in different cases. Now let us start with subtraction of integers. Subtraction of integers. Let me start with an example. Okay, so 6 minus minus 2. 6 minus minus 2. How will you subtract this minus 2 from 6? So to subtract an integer from another integer, what you have to do is, instead of subtracting, add the additive inverse of the second integer to the first integer. Okay? So, equal to 6 plus, don't subtract, and instead of subtracting symbol, you just put plus. So, 6 plus additive inverse of the second. What is the number here? Minus 2. So, what is the additive inverse of minus 2? It is plus 2. So, 6 plus 2, which is equal to 8. Is the answer. 6 minus minus 2 is equal to 6 plus 2, which is 8. So 8 is the answer. Okay. Now 3 minus minus 5. 3 minus minus 5 equal to 3 plus. What is the additive inverse of minus 5? It is positive 5, right? So 3 plus 5, which is 8. Again, you are getting the answer as 8 itself in this case also. Let us take another example. Minus 4 minus positive 6. Okay? Minus 4 minus positive 6 equal to, first integer should not be changed, minus 4 itself. Then, here it is minus, make it plus. Additive inverse of positive 6 is minus 6. Additive inverse of positive 6 is minus 6. Okay, so now you are getting minus 4 plus minus 6. And what is the answer? When you have to add two negative integers, you have studied already in the last class. When you have to add two negative integers, just add the two integers without considering this sign. Add the integers and put negative sign. So what is the answer? Minus 10. 6 plus 4 it is 10. Put negative. Minus 10 is the answer. Okay. Now one more example. Minus 8 minus 9. Minus 8 minus 9. Which is equal to minus 8 plus second one, positive 9. What is additive inverse of positive 9? It is minus 9. So minus 8 plus minus 9. Again you are getting two negative integers to add, right? So just add without considering this sign. Add the numbers and put negative sign. So minus 17 is the answer. So this is how to subtract an integer from another integer. In order to subtract two integers, just add the additive inverse of the second integer to the first integer. Okay? So now let us move on to the multiplication of integers. Multiplication of integers. So this is how you do subtraction. Okay? Next is multiplication of integers. Multiplication of integers. Multiplication of integers. You have already studied to multiply integer, right? Have studied already? Yes or no? Yeah. Okay, we'll see once again. Multiplication of integers. Let us take an example. Minus 2 into minus 3. How will you do this? How will you multiply minus 2 and minus 3? Okay, so when two negative integers are to be multiplied, just multiply the integers without considering the sign. 2 into 3, 2 3s are 6, and put positive sign. So 2 3s are 6. Positive, right? One more example. Minus 4 into minus 2. Minus 4 into minus 2. Multiply the two integers without considering the sign. 4 2s are 8. Now minus minus positive. So what did you understand from this? When you multiply two negative integers, the answer, the product will be always a positive integer. Right? Yes. Now let us take one negative integer and one positive integer. Okay? One negative integer, minus 7 into positive 3. Minus 7 into positive 3. In this case, what you have to do is just multiply the two integers, 7 and 3, numbers. Multiply the whole numbers without considering their sign. Multiply the numbers and give negative sign. Minus 21. Okay. One more example. 6 into minus 8. 6 into minus 8. What is the product? 6 8s are 48. Now since one is positive and one is negative, the product will be negative. So when you have to multiply a positive integer and a negative integer, the product will be always negative. When you are multiplying two negative integers, the product will be always positive. Okay? So what happens when you multiply three or more negative integers? Let us check. Okay? Multiplying integers where all the three integers are negative. For example, minus 3 into minus 2 into minus 4. All the three integers are negative. Minus 3 into minus 2 into minus 4. So in this case, how many negative integers are multiplied? 3. We are going to multiply 3 negative integers. That means odd number of integers. Then what happens when you multiply odd number of negative integers? The product will be always negative. So product will be negative. What is the product of 3, 2 and 4? 3, 2s are 6. 6 fours are 24. Minus 24 is the product answer. Okay, you have multiplied 3 negative integers. But what happens when you multiply 4 negative integers? Example, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. Here you are multiplying 4 negative integers. So in this case, when you are multiplying even number of negative integers, the product will be always positive. Okay, here you are multiplying 4 negative integers. So the product will be positive. 2 3s are 6, 6 5s are 30, 30 into 4, 120, right? So positive 120 is the answer. So children, when you multiply all number of negative integers, the product will be negative, whereas the product of even number of negative integers will be always positive. Okay, so when you multiply 7 negative integers, the product will be negative. When you multiply 8 negative integers, the product will be positive. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let us move on to the division of integers, where the numerator will be negative, denominator will be positive, or in the opposite way. Okay, let us consider the division of integers. Division of integers. Division of integers. Let's take the first case where the numerator is positive and the denominator is negative. Numerator is positive, okay, and the denominator is negative. 40 divided by minus 5. Here the numerator is positive and the denominator is negative. In this case, just divide numerator by denominator without considering their sign. Okay, so what will be the answer? 8, right? Now give negative sign. Give negative sign. So when denominator is negative and the numerator is positive, the answer will be always negative. The quotient will be always negative. Okay, now the second case, same numbers we will consider. Minus 40 divided by 5. Here numerator is negative and the denominator is positive. So here also the answer will be negative 8. Here also the quotient will be negative. Minus 40 divided by 5 equal to minus 8. Okay, so when the numerator is positive and the denominator is negative, the quotient or the answer will be negative. Again, if the numerator is negative and the denominator is a positive integer, then also it will be a negative integer. Okay, now let us move on to the third case where both the numerator and denominator is negative. Minus 36 divided by minus 9. Minus 36 divided by minus 9. When both the numerator and the denominator is negative, you will get the answer, you will get the quotient as a positive integer. Minus 36 divided by minus 9. You have to divide 36 by 9, that is 4, and put positive sign. When both numerator and denominator are negative, put positive sign. Okay, one more example. Minus 72 divided by minus 8. So what you have to do is just divide 72 by 8. Okay, we will get the quotient. Your answer is 9. 72 by 8 is 9. And give or put positive sign. This is the third case. So you have completed division of a positive integer by a negative integer, negative integer by a positive integer. In both those cases, the answer was a negative integer, whereas here both numerator and denominator were negative and the The answer is a positive integer. Is it okay? Clear to you? Okay, now let us take some examples from all the cases. Let us solve some problems. Okay? -3. This is subtraction. Tell me, children, how will you do it? We have completed the subtraction of integers, multiplication of integers, and division of integers. Now, solve it. 9 minus -3. What will be the answer? In order to subtract, you have to add the additive inverse of the second integer to the first integer. Okay, 9 plus -3. What is the additive inverse of -3? +3. So 9 plus 3, which is 12. +12 is the answer. Okay, so this is about subtraction. One more example, can I give you? Yes. Same integers I will take, but sign I am going to change. -9 minus +3. What will be the answer? -9 minus +3. Here, -9 plus, what is the additive inverse of +3? It is -3, right? Okay. Now here both the integers are negative and you have to add. So what should be done? Just add the integers without considering their sign. Okay, it is 12. And put negative sign. Okay, so -12 is the answer. Is it okay? Now one more example. -9 minus -3. What will be the answer? -9 minus -3. -9 plus +3. Additive inverse of -3 is +3. So -9 plus +3. Here, one is negative, one is positive. You have to add. So what you have to do? Just subtract the smallest integer from the biggest without considering the sign. Subtract. 9 minus 3 is 6. And what is the sign of the biggest integer? -9. This is +3 minus. Okay? So -6 is the answer. So this is about subtraction. Now, some more questions from multiplication. Okay? Children, do it along with me. -9 into -4 into +3. Just check the answer. -9 into -4 into +3. So in this case, first you multiply the first two integers. -9 into -4. You have already studied. What is the answer? When you multiply two negative integers, the product will be always positive. Okay, so 9 fours are 36. You will get it as +36, right? Yes. Into 3. What will be the answer? 108. +108 is the answer. So in this case, you are getting two negative integers here together. So it should be multiplied where you will be getting the product as +36 into the next number 3. So you will get 3 6 6 into 3 18 1. Okay, 108. So this is how you multiply numbers where there are negative integers as well as positive integers. Okay. Now one example for division also. -81 divided by 9. This is an easy question. How will you do it? -positive. Negative integer, positive integer. When you divide a negative integer by a positive integer, answer will be negative. What about the number -9 is the answer. Okay. So this is how you solve the problems with subtraction, multiplication and division of integers. You need some more examples? Okay, I will give one more with division. Okay. -64 by -8. What will be the answer? Both the numbers are negative. -64 by -8. So just divide 64 by 8. What is the answer? 8. Since both are negative, you will be getting a positive answer. Okay, +8 is the answer. Correct? One more. -54 54 by positive 6. Minus 54 by positive 6. Or let me change the sign. 54 by minus 6. What will be the answer? Tell me. 54 is a positive integer. This is a negative integer. So when numerator is positive and denominator is negative, the answer will be negative itself, right? Minus 9 is the answer. Okay? I hope you all understood.